At the war's end, Chuck returned to his new family and his old job at GE. Before his son, Thomas John, was born on August 16, 1947, Chuck was already a young man on the rise at GE. After taking the company's business training course, he was assigned to GE's staff of traveling auditors at the huge plant in Schenectady, New York, where Thomas Edison had started the company in 1886. This was a plum assignment for promising would-be executives, and Chuck was proud to get it. The traveling auditors were dispatched to GE plants all over the world, and often were away from home for months at a time. Dolores resented being left alone with two small children, and grew bitter about it. After 3 years as an auditor, Chuck got a quick succession of assignments in New York and New Jersey. He moved his family 4 times in 3 years, living for the longest stretch, 2 years, in Livingston, New Jersey, before he got his first management job at a GE distribution center in Washington, D.C. The family settled in Springfield, Maryland for the next 3 years. The constant moving didn't bother Chuck. It was a price he expected to pay for his ambition. He was the quintessential company man, willing to give whatever the company asked. He lived for GE, a friend said of him after his death. GE was his life. Chuck's dedication paid off with a promotion and a transfer to Chicago, where he was to become distribution manager for GE's Hot Point Appliance Division. The family settled into a comfortable, two-story older house with a lawn and trees on Hoyne Drive in South Chicago, and Chuck, a golfer, joined the nearby prestigious Midlothian Country Club. Janie and Tom had attended private schools in Washington, and in Chicago both were enrolled at Morgan Park Academy, only a few blocks from their home.